Good morning, students. Today's class we are going to revise chapter 2. Okay, you can take your NCERT textbook and your rough note, and after the session you can work out the problems from the chapter 2. Okay, children. Now you can take chapter 2 whole numbers. So what is meant by whole numbers? Whole numbers is a collection of natural numbers and zero. It starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. It is infinite. Okay. Next, predecessor successor means what? If you want to find the previous number, you will do the predecessor, which is minus 1. Successor means if you want to find the next number, you will add 1 to that number, so you will get the successor. Okay. So this is what given in your introduction part. Okay, so then they have given, see, the definition of whole number. Natural numbers along with zero form the collection of whole numbers. Okay, next they have given how to represent the whole numbers on the number line. 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. like that. Okay, starts from zero, that you know, right? Next, they have given using the number line what and all operations we can do. Next is your exercise 2.1. So in this exercise, what we have done, what we are going to do, we are going to find the next three natural numbers. Next means what you will do, add 1 to this number, you will get the next number. Then add 1 to that number, you will find the next number. Like that, you can find the next three whole numbers. So this exercise is like a 1 mark question, so you can learn everything. So this also, before means minus 1. Next, predecessor successor problems are there. Then greater, smaller, we should identify. Then few true or false questions are given. Next, properties of whole numbers. So what are the properties of whole number? Closure property. It is closure under addition and multiplication. Okay. See, it is given, right? Whole numbers are closed under addition and multiplication. Next. Any whole number divided by 0 is not defined. So children, keep it in your mind. In denominator, 0 should not come. If it is coming, it is not defined. Okay, that you should keep it in your mind. That's what given here. See, division of a whole number by 0 is not defined. Next, a commutative property. It is satisfied for addition and multiplication. That is what given, right? A plus B equal to B plus A, or A into B equal to B into A. Okay? So commutative, addition and multiplication are commutative for whole numbers. Okay? Next, associative is also satisfied for addition and multiplication. Okay? There are few example problems given here. You can refer that example problems. Okay? See here also example 2, 3. It is given, just work out the example problem. Next, distributive property of multiplication over addition. What is the property? A into B plus C equal to A into B plus A into C. Okay. So that is a distributive property given. Example problems is also given. You should work out exercise as well as example. Next, identity. Actually, additive identity is 0, multiplicative identity is 1. Keep it in your mind. Additive identity is 0, multiplicative identity is 1. Exercise 2.2. Exercise 2.2, children. First problem is find the sum using suitable rearrangement. So we have to arrange this. Three numbers are there, so you can add first any two numbers first and find the answer. With that answer, you add the third one. Here also, 2, 2 you can add it and you will find the answers. With that answer, you can add both the values. Okay, then you should find the product using suitable rearrangement. Here they ask you to find the values, so multiply using properties. better use the property. If you want to exchange any two numbers, use the commutative property. And if multiplication and addition comes in the same thing, use distributive property. If three numbers comes, use the associative property. Yes, I have already taught you in this problems. Okay, you can refer your FAIR notes for if you have any doubt. And you have word problems also. Okay, few word problems are there. That you see this type of problems are 738 into 103. How you will write 738 into 100 plus 3, 100 plus 2, 1000 plus 8, 1000 plus 5. Like that you should do these problems. Okay. Next, there is a patterns in whole numbers they have given. This is just a theory part. Just go through it. Okay. That's enough. Next is your next exercise. What is your next exercise? Exercise 2.3. So in exercise 2.3, just you should learn the rules. Okay, they have given only the rules. There is a rule, only rules given. In this type of problems, you should find, you multiply it and you find whether it does not represent zero. And you have to justify this problem with examples. Okay, you can refer the FAIR notes, children, once, just I have recalled, that's all. Okay, third question is also your product of two whole numbers. They have given a situation, you have to explain that using an example. This question using distributive property. Okay, 101, how you will write? 100 plus 1, 1001, 1000 plus 1, 25, 20 plus 5, 125, 100 plus 120, 100 plus 25. 30 plus 5 you can do, okay? Only that's all this exercise or this chapter over. You can take your rough note and start working out the problems, okay? Today's class, we have discussed chapter 2 where we know what is meant by whole numbers and how to solve the problems using those properties. You can start working out the problems now. And if you have any doubt, check your FAIR notes and then you can work it out. Okay, my dears? Thank you.